bit. I can still remember that epic stage in the Giro when he rides into the snow. I think he had two broken collarbones, a broken bib and tip, but you got through it. What were you thinking about that day to get through that stage?
I was really focused on our bridge-to-bridge ride. And that, my whole career has gone through this, riding from a very famous bridge, the infamous bridge, to Waterloo, and the Bowen Head, right from Sydney to Bowen Head.
I thought you were going to say your whole career has been worked towards being on the finisher. So I'll be the natural
reason. Andy Hampson, you take this mic, and I'll let the boys wrap you.
Now, you guys are doing a very big ride. Tell us a bit about that.
We're actually doing a fundraiser, and a group of guys from the Bowen Head Cycle Club decided to get together and ride from Sydney to Bowen Head. So we're doing a race day, and it'll be about 160k's over. We're raising money for So
that sounds like a long way.
There's no shortcut in Sydney, is there?
No.
We're going over the mountains or?
No, we're going over the coast.
They're still pretty hilly.
Yeah.
Going down the Hume or something.
Less hilly. Less hilly than through the mountains. So, that's the challenge. And it's probably more challenging considering the age of some of our riders. It's not the other one here,
guys. And how many in the group?
There are 9 riders, and we've got 1 rider.
Good, so if it gets really cold or really hot, there's no room in that car for 9, so you committed. So what's the course? Tell us about the course.
We're driving up on the Friday night, we're going to get towards Sydney, and the next morning on Saturday we'll head to Sydney and ride down to Wollongong, and we're doing about 150 to 180 k's per day.
You should take the time, it would be way easier. That seems like a really hard way to do it.
It's probably a good idea, but maybe Phil, you could give us some tips about doing a long tour like this, which we would be doing our training.
Well, I reckon after day 2, the second pair of shorts.
Sorry.
I suggest talking to Dr. Ferrari, actually.
You've already got your route place marked out, so, you can't sort of ease into it. You've got your 140, 150, 160 k's a day to do. So it's you're all going out together, coming in together, you sleep sticking together. You're not all going to be attacking each other. So just ease into it. I mean, if you're having a good day, consider maybe spending a bit more time on the front rather than going too hard. And, over a 3-week tour, such as Tour de France, you have good and bad days, and you always want to save up the energy, just don't try and be the hero and push out the watch. Too hard.
Have you worked out a way to penalise anyone who's half-wheeling? I'm guessing there's going to be some half-wheeling.
There will be a lot. Considering our loose group of cyclists, have you got any tips? What do you do? How do we deal with that?
What I like to do, this is a trick taught to me by Tim O'Shaughnessy, is when somebody is half-wheeling, you just give a little kick and roll up next to them, and just for a second, just grab the handlebar. Stop really quickly.
Might stop that tomorrow.
Back in the old days when we had shifters on the down tube, that's cool. They half wheelie, you just roll up next to them and just flick them into the highest throttle. You can't do that anymore.
No, our bikes are pretty new. 5-6 years old.
All made out of plastic. I just started riding one of these plastic bikes. They're fantastic. I have to say.
Andy, what's the age of your old squad?
60. We've got 260
year olds?
Yeah.
260 year olds, yeah. That's 120.
That's how you
spell. Yeah, Greg Lamont. Come on.
Oh, so they're quite young. Quite young, Phil. Yeah.
And the youngest? Who's the youngest?
You.
No, not me. I'm hitting with 50. I don't know.
Is it all?
Who's the Mikey? Who's the
Mikey?
How
are
you? Yes, mate. Is
it all dudes?
It is all dudes. We have a few girls who ride us weekdays, but all dudes ride the
best. Fantastic. And tell us a little bit about you, where you live. That's what we really want to know.
Okay, so it's a local charity in Geelong. and all the money raised goes to Kiwi Youth, so they distribute it amongst different needy groups around the Geelong region.
How much do you hope you raise?
We started off trying to raise $5,000 the first thing, but no, it's not really any good, so we're sort of thinking about $20,000.
Mm-hmm. Pretty good.
Everything.
Mm.
Yeah.
Does any of it go, so when you said needy organisations, does any of it go to the Barwon Recycling Fund?
Probably should have all considered the ability of our group.
Just to cover the cost of these amazing shirts. I'm getting this one, by the way.
Can you wash it? Oh,
no, it's not coming back.
Alright, we need to raise, we need, now need to raise $3,000 and $20.
Wrong one. Now, I live here, I moved down here and just before my son was born, and he's about to turn 10.
Yep.
So, where the hell were you guys when I was living here? When I was living here? There was no Barwon Recycling Club.
There wasn't. I think Ned was out riding with a couple of the guys.
Okay.
I remember when I met Ned, and he said to me, you know, you should join us riding. Oh, I don't know about that. Because I used to ride, I used to commute, I've always ridden my bike to work, and he said, come on, join us.
I knew Steve Draper a little bit, like,
the
mountain biking that, but there doesn't seem to be much of a cycling.
No, it was just a sort of very loose group of guys. And
so I live in Anglesey, and everyone's trying to get some sort of Anglesey club together, but it's damn hilly there.
Yeah.
Here it's just flat, everywhere you go, it's flat, it's great. Anglesey is just, any way out of that town is up.
Yeah,
so no, I'm not into that.
You only get the wind, though.
You do get the wind, yes.
We're heading down 13th Street.
Mm-hmm.
You want to get the west leaf blowing your face. You like to get on the way to Brimley.
Yeah, not so much on the way back.
Great tailing on the way back. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
absolutely. Who are some of the personalities in this room from this bar with this side of the boat? Because there's always trouble. I'm looking at a big lanky dude up the back. What's going on? He's lurking.
No, Greg, we can't speak. We speak very kindly to Greg because he owns the ice cream shop.
Hey!
We won't say Greg.
I'll be in town for breakfast.
Yes. And he hands out plenty of ice cream for Christmas party, which is a great event. That's fantastic.
Yep.
Probably if I threw it out to the crowd and asked who it was, I would say I would get Wiggle as one of the personalities.
Hey!
He's got a whole online store.
That's right. He's putting an order into Wiggle. Anyone want one? And we used to email him everything we needed. All the prices he sent, and he comes and delivers it to us.
The bike shops love this. That's why Steve Draper's not.
Yeah, that's right. That's Wiggle. He's probably our most well known. And tonight we found Greg Lamond, right?
We found Greg, yes.
Yeah.
So, Andy, if people want to donate to Bridge,
yes,
and give where you live, what we're going to do is Norm, our editor and producer, he's going to make a phone number or a web address appear on my hand.
And on my hand. There he is.
And on
my forehead.
How do we pronounce that?
Give where you live. Just type it, give where you live.
Givewhereyoulive.com.
Yeah, bridge to bridge.
Bridge to bridge.
Or is it Peter Pete?
Norm's going to research all of this after
somewhere here. So, actually speaking, Norm, I've got to say thanks. He's apparently on board Lennox and Trailer. Well, he doesn't know that.
He's not going to know that, but we're going to save that for surprise.
Oh, good. All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Still like that.
If you're interested in donating to give you where you live, Bridge, yes, that address again.
There it is.